the only reason why negative feelings keep increasing is because you want to suppress them.
Yes.
There is great pleasure in suppression of negative feelings. You see, whether you enhance the feeling or you suppress it, ultimately you get a sense of power. The ego says, I am suppressing. Or, I am being entertained. A far better thing is to just see what all that feeling is all about. You have a healthy mind. Look at that feeling. Why do I repeatedly keep getting this feeling? What does this feeling say? Ask the feeling, what do you want? Miss feeling, what really is your demand? Why do you keep coming again and again? And you are welcome. It's not that I want to expel you from my house. I'm not suppressing you. But I want to know that why are you a recurrent visitor to my home? Ask it. And to ask that, you'll have to be friends with that feeling. Not think that that feeling is your enemy. Because 1,000 feelings will come to you. Envy, jealousy, fear, hatred, competition, ambition. You cannot fight them all. There is no need to fight them. There is no need to fight them. What to do with them?
Forget about them.
Forget about that thing.
Let go.
Or ignore that.
We need a second thought that it is not compulsory and we have to drop that thought at that place.
Even these things that, three things that you said, forget them, ignore them, or say that it is not compulsory, are you really friends with that feeling? If you are friends with somebody, do you ignore them?
No.
Do you forget them? Do you say that you are not compulsory? All these three words that you just said, they came from fear. You are afraid of that feeling, that is why that feeling keeps coming again and again. Have guts, be courageous. When that feeling comes, say, ah, the feeling has come again. Right. Let's sit down like friends and talk. Miss feeling, what do you want? Why ignore it? Can you ignore it? Are you actually ever able to ignore it? It destroys your mood. And if something is able to destroy your mood, are you actually ignoring it or becoming a victim?
Victim.
You are saying forget it. Are you able to forget it? There is no way you can forget
it. Just like killing our enemy, we self become an enemy. You should change that enemy.
And that thought is you. At that moment, that is what your real identity is. It's like trying to defeat one hand with using another hand. Which hand will win? Which hand will win? Using one thought, you are trying to conquer another thought. And both the thoughts are there in? Which hand will win? No hand will win. You will be defeated. You will be exhausted. So, first thing, accept yourself. Drop this approach that something needs to be controlled. Nothing needs to be controlled. It's all fine, good, all right. You only need to understand, not control. Understand, not control. The urge to control comes from a moralistic mind. It comes from a violent mind. It comes from a mind that has already been tutored that something is good and something is bad, something needs to be controlled. Nothing needs to be controlled. Everything is all right. There is nothing in existence which needs to be controlled. Everything just needs to be
understood.
Understood. And to understand something, you need to be friends with it.
Say example.
Whatever, what do you want to control? Come close to that.
Like anger, how to...
How can you control anger? Do you look at people, do you actually find them able to control anger? People flare up at the flimsiest of reasons. Sometimes there is no reason to get angry and people are so angry. And you're looking at them and wondering what's wrong with him. And after 2 hours, you are in the same shoes. Getting angry for nothing. Who can control anger? When anger comes, ask, tell yourself, I'm getting angry again. And this anger is because I wanted something, I didn't get it. The expectations are being hurt, so anger is normal. But to do this, you'll have to have two things. One, honesty. Second, courage. Why honesty? Because, you know, we get certain pleasure in anger. Have you experienced that? You are frustrated. And then when you are able to shout at somebody, what do you get?
Pleasure.
A certain pleasure. It is because of this pleasure that you want to be angry. And then you ask me how to control anger. Huh? Isn't it so? That we want to be angry. And that is the reason why after you have been angry, you sometimes feel peaceful, nice, good. The ego has had a massage. I was able to shout at him. So I'm feeling good. Because there is a pleasure in anger. So be honest. That I am the one who is nurturing anger all the time. That is the part about honesty. The second part about courage. When anger comes, I'm repeating, be friends with it. Not enemies. Not enemies. Anger is there. All right, anger is there. What's the big deal? It's there with everyone. Why get all worked up about it? I'm angry. Changing your Facebook status, angry. Why? It's all right. Anger is not something alien.
So do you get angry?
Anger comes. There is no doubt about it. Now whether I get angry or not, that is another matter.
So how to understand it? By asking questions to ourselves?
No, by being aware that it is coming. Let it not enter like a thief. You don't even know. And it has made some kind of backdoor entry. Anger has come. You stand upon the door and say, "Welcome, sir. Again you have come. All the time you want to come." It comes. Till the time there are situations, there is body, there will be reasons for anger to come. But there is no reason for you to be dominated. Let it come. And when it comes, don't feel small. Don't feel as if something very bad has happened. Breath goes in and goes out. Hunger comes. Fatigue comes. Tears come. Anger too can come. What's the big deal?